Fellas, welcome. In today's episode, we've got a wonderful experiment for y'all. We'll be revisiting something we've done in the past and making new wheels that are pretty amazing. Which isn't to say that these are bad. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's quite the contrary. But in our case, the design is going to be slightly... Actually, not slightly, but rather radically different. So people have been sending us this picture again. Like, improve on your previous iteration. Okay, let's make something better this time. For the purpose, we've gone and ordered up these lovely springs. Honestly, guys, they are pretty robust, I'm telling you. This time we should be seeing fantastic results. I do expect this wheel to perform its duties like a champ. Let's do this. Let's make us a wheel using springs. Making a sprung tire, translation and voiceover by BMI Russian. Here's the situation, fellas. The springs are fitting quite nicely, it's all good, but you can't really squeeze them in there by hand. So we're using hydraulic tools, since, well, you'd think that such measly springs wouldn't be an issue, but once you've got over a dozen of them in there, they start fighting back really hard. It does still look a bit rough, but I'm guessing that's what it would've looked like anyway. We're getting there. Look at how nice this wheel turned out. This attempt, I'd say, was way more successful. These springs are much better for this sort of task. So the rim we've wrapped around them isn't particularly thick. We made it out of steel sheet that's only about, like, 2 mm thick. Though ideally we should have been using something thicker. But if you look at it, their placement at even intervals allowed for stretching the rim out to the point where it's nice and even. And the outermost layer is some regular old tire tread. We secured it with some screws. Now, admittedly, it does look a bit lumpy, I guess you'd call it. But I don't think it's that important. Since, well, nobody's gonna be going 200 km on this. Okay, so now there's the matter of checking whether this wheel is even gonna work. As far as I can tell, I mean, the concept was invented a really long time ago. The pictures we saw were all very, and I mean very, black and white. And for whatever reason, this never got the green light. It never became a thing, and cars don't drive on wheels like this. Surprise! There are a few modern designs, though they're a bit different, and they're made using different materials. As for the sprung variant, that faded into obscurity. But we ain't gonna let it die. Time to throw it on and do some testing. Let's rock! Okay, fellas, we've mounted it, lowered the car, and it is good. Though some of the springs seem to have assumed an unnatural position. They're a bit twisted, I see. Anyway, so this is a rear-wheel drive car, which means that theoretically up front this wheel should just be rolling. There's a reason we put it here first. Okay, let's fire up the car, head out and see how it behaves on the road. I think I can feel every spring. Apparently, when the springs find their way to the bottom, the wheel becomes stiffer. But when you're going over bumps, nope, they are chattering, meaning that they're fully compressing. Some coil-on-coil action. I guess we needed stiffer springs. But this was all they had in stock. So, on a relatively smooth road, it rides decently. You got grip, the car drives, it's all good. When you're just going down the road. So when you hit the seams where the concrete slabs meet, cracks and all of that, you do get a sneaking suspicion that the springs are indeed compressing all the way, which results in some harshness. Then again, it's nothing too crazy. And I also noticed, so you see the wheel we made? It's lacking any sort of retainers. You know what I'm talking about, right? Something that'd prevent the outer rim from moving side to side. Honestly, that I can definitely feel. You can really feel how it's squirming, left, right. If we were to install some restrictors like on that picture, I mean those round shackle-looking things, it seems to me that they're meant to keep everything in check. They are meant to compress. And so they're what's keeping the inner rim, let's call it, to which the springs are attached, from shifting relative to the outer rim. That said, you've got some wobble, but the car is moving, which is pretty nice. At a certain point, you can feel it giving you a slight hit. Okay, there seems to be a problem. So here's what's up. We've removed the rubber, and we're running on bare metal. So this is how it was meant to be, apparently. Though ours is a bit wider. Then again, you can't really tell on that picture how wide that wheel actually is. And I'm expecting to hear some very pleasant sounds of metal scraping against concrete, pavement, rocks. That's always delightful. If I were to guess, I'd say that's why this concept never gained any traction. All right, let's carry on with our experiment. Time to ride on bare metal. Everything seems to be okay. I didn't feel any changes. It works beautifully. Problem is, without the rubber layer, it is now super noisy. Okay, so up front, everything is fine, but it's time we relocate it to the rear. See how it behaves back there. This is a rear-wheel drive automobile, after all. Now I'm gonna drive over all of them ruts. It is way more supple with that wheel in the back, probably because it's under way less stress, as in there's less weight pushing down on it, with the rear end of the car weighing less, so it's not having such a hard time anymore. The car is actually pretty nice to drive. This ain't half bad. And now it's time for some durability testing. To see how exceptionally it holds up. It is digging into the ground quite a bit. I mean to say that it's keeping it together. It was even kicking up some dirt. How is it even picking it up? Wheel spin? Let me go have a look, I am super curious. Whoa, it dug in pretty deep. Not bad. Interestingly enough, it dug into the dirt. Like, it dug a hole. Now let's drive that way. Doesn't matter that we... Oh, it wasn't just us driving in the mud. It actually looks like someone got stuck here. Oh, but here it is very nice. So compliant. It is going over all of those ruts and bumps very nicely. It's staying quiet. I don't hear any screeching noises. Fabulous. The underbody is taking a bit of punishment, but no worries. What really counts is the maneuvers. Driving over this type of road is quite a pleasant experience. Okay, fellas, this was a pretty awesome one. This was not like the time we were running just the springs. This time we've got a rim going, and a lot of springs. 36 of them to be exact, and they are very much up to carrying the weight of the car, but only if the wheel is mounted back here. So on a side note, if I'm being completely honest with you, that's all they had in stock. So they were enough to make a wheel, which if you place it up front... So from the looks of it, the springs are fully compressed back here as well, though the ride isn't nearly as harsh as when it's mounted up front. So, I mean, the car is empty, but anyway, up front you got the motor, meaning that you've got more weight pressing down onto the front axle. And so when going over some of the rougher bumps, over cracks in the road and such, the springs rapidly compress. That's when you really feel a jolt going through the suspension. Okay, I'd say this was a tremendous success. It's definitely a pretty neat concept. And that's all I have for you. Watch us, subscribe, send in your comments, your suggestions, give us a big thumbs up. Alright, catch you later. I got me this new hat today. The one I used to have is on its way to another country. But I digress. Go ahead and grab yourself some merch. There's gonna be a link in the description. And on that note, catch you later.